Hello again. Time for another doodle. This time it is a commission. Oh, I've actually got a few commissions from some of you guys, which is very kind. That's all on my Ko-fi page. This one is from Martin Willis, who you guys should all check out. He's a very funny man. And he runs a gig at the Albany Pub in Great Portland Street in London, which you should check out when we're out of quarantine, called Objectively Funny, and you should follow Objectively Funny on Instagram, because Facebook went mad and deleted his account because it got hacked, and they kind of punished him for it, which is not very fair. Anyway, he puts together, or helps to put together, a pamphlet about mental health, and he wants one of my doodles on the page, possibly as an example of what poor mental health can do to your art skills. Who knows? And he's very kindly given me a free hand in what that looks like. So let's get drawing. I'll move this horrible giant paintbrush out of the way so we're not even tempted to go near it. Terrible. Let's see. Now I'm going to do this in what you might call my usual style, which is very loose and possibly bad. Let's find out. Let's find out how it looks. So I want, it's gonna be people sat around a table. So let's do the back of the table. And the front of the table is probably beyond what we can see. And is that right? Should that curve be a little softer? No, that's good. That's about the right kind of table. And now these are the people having a chat right near the front here. Here are their big heads, their bodies vaguely. And do some real quick noses so you can see they're looking at each other. They're going to have a chat with each other here. And isn't that going to be nice? And then going to have this corner of someone's face here, and then this person is going to be having a lovely chat with them. Their body here in some fashion, and then this person is going to be having a lovely chat to someone who we can't quite see here. And maybe make this a bit further along. And then in the middle here, we're going to have the person who is, maybe they're feeling sad or disassociated. That's kind of, well, it's not necessarily worse than feeling sad. It's different, but it's very, very unsettling. If anyone watching is ever dissociated, they'll know. It's not, it's not fun. Wouldn't recommend it. And the writing's going to go here. We're going to put some writing up there. So, remembering our perspective rules, let us get some ink. This is going to be nice and messy, although I did feel like I just... Normally I wouldn't even do sketching a pencil outline, but I did feel like I should be a responsible boy and do that. So that's good. I don't think we'll need this chap, this nice steel ruler. So we'll move him out of the way. Okay, now let's get some ink on this pen. There we go. Na-na-na-na-na. We're in the money. I've been in my head all day, and I'm not in the money. Not any more than usual, anyway. Now let's see. Big laugh. They're having an absolute whale of a time, these people. Only lower teeth. That's sort of the upsetting kind of thing that we want.
I've decided on your behalf. Only lower teeth and a big tongue there. And some noses here. Nostril time. What was your favorite time of the day as a kid? Mine was nostril time. I want the impression that she's throwing her head back, this person. Having an absolute... absolutely marvelous time. So I'm trying to loosen up my strokes here. I'm getting too... Even trying to be a loose boy now, I'm still too... not nearly loose enough compared to what I'm used to. What I used to do when I was young. Let's get looser. Looser, loose like Lucifer. It's a little gigantic, but we can forgive that, can't we? We're a forgiving society, aren't we, at the end of the day, when it comes to people with a giant head? She looks a bit more like she's yawning, but that's all right. Or something. I felt like now that they're around a table, they should be dressed like people who were going out to dinner in the, I would say, mid-80s. The start of some cleavage. And then big shoulder pads. If she's going to be really from the 80s. And then... I don't quite know what I'm doing with this. And then this guy. This guy's going to be... sort of leering butler. And that's what this is going to be. Hardly any nose at all. Nostrils. Big eyebrows. Horrible little face. Apologies to anyone who looks exactly like this guy. You wouldn't trust that guy with your mortgage, would you? Not that anyone's going to have a mortgage anytime soon. That's a very old-fashioned thing to even say, isn't it, these days? That's all right. We'll find a way through. Brow overhang here. He's very evil-looking, this guy. Made that a kind of Dali mustache now, as opposed to an evil cheek. But it didn't look like a cheek, so we're just going to get away with it. Make him look like he's... they're in a fancy dinner. They're in black tie, it turns out. Occasion is the annual dinner for hideous freaks. Perhaps. I've heard it's a wonderful dinner. They really lay on a good spread. There we are. There's Hooded Nick. And I think we do want some particularly mad hair there. There we are. Now we can get the big brush and let's tease this out from the blob. You guys remember the blob from all the other episodes. It's our old friend, the blob, again. That's nice. That looks like weird comb over hair, doesn't it now? That's exactly the sort of thing this guy would do. Was the comb over ever a good idea? Did it ever work? Was there a period during the Victorian era where people were like, wow, I thought that guy was bald, but he's not bald? And then later they were like, wait a minute. Like, wait a minute, that guy's bald. How did you do that? And then, maybe that's what the Illuminati is. It was started as a way of making sure that anyone smart enough to figure out what a comb-over was didn't blab about it to the press or to women. Those easily tricked ladies who definitely weren't just being polite. There we go, we've managed to preserve the folds a little bit. But not so perfectly, to be honest with you. That's O. Okay. We can edit this. Lapel. I was talking to someone the other day, and I can't for the life of me remember who it was, but I wouldn't tell you anyway. But they'd never heard the word lapel. And they... It was one of those conversations where I said, but what would you call the bit on a maybe a jacket or a blazer or something where you might put a pin badge? I said, oh, I don't know. And that was it. Very unsatisfying. Do some eyebrow hair. Look at that. There we go. Absolute. This guy's got brows for days. And while we're here. And this is the wrong kind of brush for this, because that's a lot of curved lines there. And this is a square boy. But we're breaking all the rules today. I don't know if you noticed how many rules we've been breaking lately, but oh boy. We can't break the rules by going outside too many times. But we're going to break the rules like this. I almost screwed that up, but not quite. Thank the Lord. Need to shade anything else in? I don't think so. Right then. Back to your slumber, Mr. Brush. We don't need you for now. We may call upon your services later. But for now, you sleep. Okay, the nice thing about that is that it does dry so very quickly. And that is the dream. Now that we've done the people in the foreground, we can do... the edge of the table there. Nice. There we go. And maybe we'll put things on the table. Maybe we won't. I'm just going to do a big old Roman schnoz here. A big old 1950s movie star schnoz. Big old I'm Spartacus chin. eyebrow and some forehead. There we go. And lovely neck, and then that's them there. And because we're being all quick and so on, we can just be fiddly quick. Now, what kind of hairstyle are we talking about here? An old 1950s thing. Alright, come on, Pierre, let's get looser. You keep talking about wanting to be loose. Let's get loose. There we go. And the earrings can be here. Earrings, and then she's going to be like very interested in whatever this guy is saying, or at least sarcastically pretending to be. He's going like this. Ooh. She's absolutely... There we go. She's a little line across there, like Garfield face. And now she's a little less impressed, isn't she? Got good bone structure, though. Good for her. Oh, there we go. Now she's all thin and pointy. As all people should be. I think we can all agree on that. Everyone should be thin and pointy. There we are. She's wearing, I don't know what she's wearing. I just realized that no one's holding a drink. She should be holding a drink. Hairstyles I find very difficult because I'm not interested in them visually. I'm interested in grotesque flesh. His hair is too malleable. If you have grotesque flesh, you can't really avoid it, as I well know. whereas hair is it's tricky stuff. This lady can have one of those mad top bun things that people get sometimes. Sometimes you'll see one of those at a formal dinner, and I always think it looks strange. Now, what could we make absolutely horrible about this person? Let's make it that I don't really have a face at all. A really tiny, weird little face there. Tiny eyes. Anyone who likes Vic and Bob? Tiny eyes. Like two tiny butter beans. Tiny eyes. So tiny and small. She's going to have a lot of face going on. As much face as we can give her. Get this woman more face. Stat. And then it's all going to go down to a sort of insane little... Oh, that's blobbing a bit. This is not the time. A black dress. And she's got her elbows on that table. She's rude. No. And there's a line there, but it doesn't matter. thumb and her spiky hand around an absolutely massive glass of wine. Absolute chalice there. That doesn't work, so we're going to cover it up. Thank you, Blob. The Blob was wiser than any of us knew. It knew that a mistake had been made. It's going to help us cover it up like a good friend after a terrible murder. There we are. Now, in hindsight, that means that this lady's not nearly spiky enough. So we're going to give her all sorts of horrible spiky lines. There we are. Yes. Pointy. She's a pointy lady, much bigger nostrils, it's changed the shape of her face. We're going to give her... Oh, I need to do some lines on here. There we are. Now she looks normal. We're going to give her black hair too. Maybe she's related to the other man with the insane face. Hard to say. Hard to say. The interpersonal relationships of these characters are a mystery to us. Big old brows. Big monobrow. Horrible. Right, now a diluted version of this needs to go on this collar. Have you ever seen that? Sometimes with really fancy jackets, they've got a slightly lighter lapel, or a maybe it's made of velvet, even black velvet sometimes, you can see. There we go, that's turned out pretty nice. I'm not unhappy with that. Here we are. Lovely. Lovely. I think we can all agree that that's absolutely charming. She's going to have grey hair, this lady. It's been a stressful life, coping with having such a tiny face. I think we can all sympathise with that. If not specifically. Well, sympathise, maybe not empathise. Empathise. Okay. Now then, let's make sure that this is all dry before we start getting saucy with anything else involved. Right, let's get one of these big old napkins that was sent in the post by my sainted mother, as repeat viewers will know. It's always best to make sure you're wearing clothes that you don't mind getting little black dots all over. I suppose all of these grotesque monsters need chairs. Do they need chairs? I suppose they do need chairs, don't they? Chair for you. A chair for you. There we go. Can I get the perspective at least moderately correct? And now, our terrible victim of some kind. I think it's just going to be a skull head. I think that's what I would feel like if I was at this terrible dinner party with these hideous beasts. Like two tiny butter beans. There we go. minutes. Tiny eyes, so tiny and small. There we go. I don't want it to look too evil. I want it to look a bit benign, if anything. So then that needs to be less angry. If you compress the top line of the eyes there, it will make it look like an angry skeleton. And that's not necessarily the mood we're going for here. It's a floating jaw there. Now we get to do some vertebra. Vertebra, vertebrae. Vertebra. Vertebrae. There we go. Now we need Mr. Brush again, and we can use some of the ink from inside the pen. Look at that. What an incredible piece of innovation from Pierre there. Even though there shouldn't really be any darkness here because it's straight through a floating skull, we're going to put it in there. We're going to put it in there because we do what we like. We do whatever we want. Yes. Oh, the chair. Yeah. That's obviously what's missing from this picture. And then a little bowl of soup. Shading on the ball here. And blobbing a bit, which is a shame, but that's okay. Mm-hmm. There we go. Fix that. Yeah. Definitely something, isn't it? We've definitely created a a scene. Sometimes it feels like some parts of the paper are just more resistant to being drawn on than others, and I don't know why that is, but it does feel that way sometimes. So let's. What are you going to do? We're going to do the letters now. Now let's see. I'm going to say the phrase is going to be, you don't have to be alone to be isolated. That's the sort of thing that people like. Pithy. Is it pithy? Let's find out. This is going to be quite hard to do. I'm going to anchor ourselves. Let's see if Pierre has judged the lettering size correctly. No, you don't have to be alone. Yes, that's right. Not bad. There we go. It's a sort of cheerful thing people like to see, isn't it? I'm sure I'll be selling postcards of this. And why wouldn't you? This guy, we'll give him a bow tie to help with the whole "what is his neck" query that I am unwilling to field. There we go. Yeah, that's certainly something. Now we can maybe make the letters a bit more defined now that we have them. I'm quite pleased with this. It's topical, but not overbearingly so. There we go. Yeah. Well, that's certainly something. That's the least we can ask for. There we go. Oh, that's come off again. Well, we shouldn't need it again, so that's okay. Let's impatiently try and... Well, actually, the front should be dry, so we should be able to get away with rubbing out stuff from the front. Get more of this. This rubber out, or again, eraser if you're an American. American. There we go. Let's do this. No more pencil lines. I think. Oh no. Oh no. You know what? We're just going to have to accept that. I think there's a way I can fix it, but oh, it's going to be tough. Oh, boy. Maybe I need Tippex. What I was saying was that I sort of regret. I sort of regret doing the pencil lines. I think I would have been looser without any guidelines at all. In hindsight, which as we all know is 2020. Well, these things happen. Maybe there's a way of covering it all up. We'll find out. We'll see. There we go. The important thing is we have our health. And if we don't have that, the important thing is that we are watching a video of a man barely coping with a basic task. And that's something, isn't it? At the end of the day, you can't take that away from us. You can only take away everything else. I don't think I'd want to go to this dinner party or restaurant or whatever it is. It doesn't look like the most fun crowd. I like to imagine that one of these two is this person's partner. That would really drive the message home. If the message is clear at all, and it might be. Right. Oh Lord, now we really are risking it, aren't we? With this erasing of ours, this obsession with clean lines. There we go. And a bit of smudging there again from the chair. It always sneaks up on you. It's always a bit of ink or a bit of lime that you didn't expect. This is why we use the hairdryer, Pierre. This is why we sit and hairdryer our work like a lunatic. I bet you that's one of the lines. No? Thought I'd outsmarted you, ink. Ah, my old enemy, ink. Right. So, look at that. That's a big problem. How did we do that? How did that happen? Oh, no. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I think we're going to have to use some acrylic. God, can you imagine? What a world. Acrylic of all things. Dear me. Dear me. You can't see, but I've got my head in my hands here. Let's try this. And obviously I could just pause the video and let it dry and have a coffee, but... For literally no reason, I refuse. It's the same thing that makes you want to carry all the shopping in one go. That sort of asinine competitiveness with yourself that's completely unnecessary. Right. Right, well, let's focus on this yelling lady. She's dry. She's dry as a bone. We can focus on her. Right. Get this out of the way. Yeah, get some watercolors ready. Let's see. Actually, get some red and orange and mix it. Get that fleshy tone going. Or a fleshy tone, rather. There we go. So let's see how this pans out. Oh, That's very orange. That won't do. Get some yellow in there too. There we go. That's better. That can be very much the general wash for her whole existence. And the lips will be darker, so we don't need to worry too much about the old outlines. Same with the hair, where we've kind of screwed the pearls a little bit. This looks a bit like that scene in The Simpsons where he's remembering being drunk and he's remembering being really witty and urbane, even though he was a savage monster boozer. They're all in sort of washed out watercolors in that scene, which I always found really odd and really funny creative choice there. The Simpsons, of all people. There we go. Bit of shading on the fly. Get those contrasts in, boys, while you can. Yeah, she's a little sunburned, but that's okay. Maybe she is sunburned. You don't know my story. That's what she's yelling. That's what she's shouting at this guy. How dare you? You don't know my story. Imagine having the confidence to yell that at someone, that they don't know your story. What would you mean by that? Your life, I suppose. Your particulars. That's the old-fashioned version of it that you can shout, "You don't know my particulars!" Internal needs to be darker, doesn't it? Because if it's not darker, then what are we playing at, really? There we go. That's the kind of red we've dreamt of, isn't it? That's the sort of red that our parents wanted for us when we were young. And it's gone over the black there in quite a smudging way, but I quite like it. You know what? I'm in favour of it. And I painted over her teeth there, but that's okay too. And why is it okay? Because we have decided that it's okay. Are there any other dark reds? None that we can do yet. There's a blob of water there. It's absolute smudge city here. I must apologize. I don't know why. I don't know what I've done to deserve this level of smudgification. Oh, this guy. This guy strikes me as being a pretty... Oh, there's a bit of hair there. Pretty pale dude, so we're gonna try and make that the case. Big old wash absolutely everywhere for this guy. Nearly went in the wrong ink there. Wrong ink, wrong water. Okay. There we go. Bit of comb over stuff happening there. Bit of this, bit of that. Sure. Now we can do his horrible little lips. Horrible little smirk there. Is there a smirk? I'd argue that it's a smirk. A smirking man at a dinner party. Is there anything less de rigueur? I think not. Now we're doing little dots of moisture here, which will try and promote that darker colour. Sometimes, when I'm filming these, and I'm saying things like that as if I know what I'm doing, or as if I do proper art, and I picture an actual artist who knows, like, the really, like, great techniques for how to do what I'm trying to do, like the proper stuff, you know. And I imagine their frustration. And I find it very embarrassing, but also kind of thrilling that they're having to watch an idiot stumble their way through their preferred craft. I imagine it's absolutely insufferable. So apologies to any of you watching who actually know how to do art. There we go. What a fleshy looking chap. As the vicar said to the whatever that joke is, I've never really understood it. Now what I'm going to do, viewers, is I'm going to get some white acrylic paint to fix these errors, because you know what? Martin Willis, from Objectively Funny Comedy, deserves only the very best. And I would feel like an unutterable worm if I were to offer him anything less than the best. Well, within the limits of my ability, which, as we've all seen, my abilities are limited. A little blob of paint there. And maybe we'll add loads of acrylic and it'll be really interesting. Yeah? It'll have lots of interesting effects. You never know, it could happen. We could become pioneers. All right, let's get the white acrylic on this chap, which I don't think we should do, because it's probably supposed to be a watercolor brush, but whatever. Now then. Well, that's sort of working, isn't it? It's working well enough for what I've got planned. Yeah, you can see it's a different white, but we'll paint over it, and no one will be any the wiser, apart from you and I. So let's keep this between us. Martin's probably going to watch the video, so he'll know. I'll probably just tell him. Why would I hide it? Why would I hide it from Martin, of all people? Martin's a very understanding man. At least he was before quarantine. Perhaps he's become fascistic and inflexible. Although I doubt it. Yeah, we also don't want to ruin this guy's hairdo, do we? The real risk here. Na-na-na. Right, that's kind of helped, hasn't it? This has not really worked though. There we go. That's a little better. Okay. What's happened there? That's had an interesting effect, hasn't it, on proceedings? He's got a very sharp eye now. Look at me. Bum, bum, bum. Right. Oh, the lettering. God bless us all, the lettering. Some of it's still wet, though. Oh, well. We've decided that we're risk takers, and we can clean this up, too. And this, God, what a lot of smearing's gone on. Dear me. It's been like an unsportsmanlike political campaign. With all the smearing that's been going on, I am available for joke writing services. Here we go, just helping it look a little more uniform. Right, now then. Oh, fixing our mistakes. It's not always possible to fix our mistakes. There's your life lesson for the day. But it's good to try. And even that is a bunch of mistakes I've made there, trying to fix this mistake. Which is another good life lesson. Sometimes you can make it worse by fiddling. Like with a cut or a graze. Dun, dun, dun. Right. Let's see if we can use the nib here to scrape off. The nice thing about blobbing the old white on is that we can go over it again in black if we don't like the correction to the correction. And we can trap ourselves in a sort of, some sort of Sisyphean loop. Isn't that exciting? Doesn't that sound like the kind of thing you'd like to be trapped in? Sisyphean loop sounds like a name for like quite a good, like an ambient music album, but it's got a bit of attitude behind it, you know. There's something a bit dark in some of the tracks. There's some interesting titles. Some interesting things mixed in there. Yeah, that'll do, he said. Generously to himself. Right, now then. Now then, now then, now then. This lady. What is to become of her and her hair? Let's just do a big bloody yellow. Bum, 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 bum. Like rays of the sun. Dun, dun, dun. There we go. Sure, why not? Why the flip not, after all? Is anything else going to be yellow? Nothing really. And the dress, the dress. Powder blue, I would say. There we are. Very light, washed out vibes from these people so far. That might change. I know as much about this as you do, to be honest, so far. Got inklings. Hey, Don't get me wrong. I've got inklings, all right. But they're not strong. And they wax and wane with the seasons. Yeah. Let's see. That dark brown color, not the one we've just used, but the really dark brown one. If I mix that with some of the fleshy tone, maybe we'll get something quite interesting, shadow-wise. Let's find out. Yeah, quite interesting. It's not blowing my mind, though. I would never say that. Hey, Pierre, are you procrastinating from writing a script? Yes, I am. That is one of the things I'm absolutely doing. I'm also procrastinating from writing a show for the Edinburgh Fringe because I don't think it's going to happen this year. I would be very surprised if it did, but they refuse to cancel it. And I'm not quite sure why. Apart from, you know, money. Oh, that's way too much. Oh, no. You've overdone it on the blusher there, madam. Yeah. That's been... There you go. This could be a makeup tutorial. Right. A bit of dark blue here for the old eyeshadow. Oh, that's too much as well. She's really gone for it, this lady. She's going to have an absolutely massive night. And he knows it. Slightly darker eyebrows. There we go. What a wonderful looking woman. What a charming looking lady that we've created here. Her head's going to get tangled in his mustache. Yes. Okay. This guy's got a sort of generic posh guy at a dinner face. Even if you've never been to a posh dinner, you can always imagine how they look. And we've all seen Titanic. And from my limited experience, that's not a bad set of assumptions to start with. There's way too much water on this. And you'll notice that I tried to cope with that by adding more. Which was foolish. There we go. He certainly exists, and that's all he needs to do there in the corner for now. Sneaky bit of water there. It's too red, so we're going to dilute that. There we are. Bit of shadow. Right. Let's see. Okay, now let's do this lady. Bum 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 bum. This will be the base color for her. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I don't know what I'm doing to this paper, but it does sometimes get a bit damaged in a way that I'm quite surprised by. I'll admit it, I'm surprised. Just trying to get back in the game. It's a bit too dark then. Kind of swamping the old vibe. I gotta totally make it more like the base color. Especially here around the old brow. And the nose. Yeah, a bit of rouge. Yes, and what about this extremely pink lady? I'm not quite sure. Extremely pink, extremely tiny face. Maybe she should be really washed out. Just completely. Excuse me. Apologies. Did you know that flamingos are only pink because of the pinkness of the little shrimps and prawns and whatever the hell it is that they eat, the little plankton things in the marshland. If you just feed them sort of pellets or whatever in the zoo, they're not pink, so they need to add pink, natural pink stuff into the food in the zoo to make sure that they're pink for everyone who's visiting, because everyone wants them to be pink. Right. Well, this lady's gonna look like a egg. There we go. Is it geishas that have a tiny mouth sometimes? They paint on like the lips smaller than they are to make the mouths look all tiny? Possibly. It could be. You don't know that it's not. Some booze there. Some more makeup here for the tiny faced lady. And the chairs, everyone's favorite. What kind of color are we going to do the chairs? Probably this guy. This is the guy for the chairs. These are the chairs for the guy. How happy are we with those? Happy enough. So you see now we're painting over the acrylic. And it's worked perfectly well. Isn't that nice? Give it some weird texture. How about that? Don't we look cultured? Mm-hmm. 232. Na 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 na. And the table, I suppose, should have a colour. Some generic sort of brown thing. Actually, given that the hair is supposed to be transparent, we should paint through those lines. Okay. There we go. Bum, bum, bum. There we are. That's sort of something, isn't it? Is that going to be the catchphrase of whatever this is, Pierre? I'm afraid it might be, you know? I'm afraid it might be. A tasteful green. A tasteful forest green. For this lady. To cover up the paint from the mistakes we made when we were younger. Because technically, even 5 minutes ago when we made the mistakes, we were younger. And let's imagine with this lady that her jewellery matches her earrings, her dress. She just loves green. She is an absolute freak for green, and who among us isn't? Indeed. And the soup can be unappetizing looking as well. As well as looking lonely. Lonely soup. Lonely soup is probably the worst kind of soup. What is the worst soup? The worst soup. Broccoli soup or anything green and gloopy. Or the pea soup maybe can be good. I don't know. There's some soups where if you say, what's the soup of the day? And they go, what's this? And you think, no. What I wanted to hear was tomato. Or leek and potato. Let's not mess around and pretend any of the other soups are worth bothering with. Mm-mm-mm. What colour the ball? Ball could be... sort of light blue thing going on there with the ball. And why not, after all? There we go. Sure. Sure. He said. Confidently. Right. Now then. Let's get some... Let's get this woman some wine. Let's get this lady some wine, for God's sake. I'm going to mix in some brown, so it looks like tannins. Have you ever noticed that when they're drinking... prop wine in a lot of TV shows. It just looks like Ribena. It's just this bright drink. There's no darkness to it at all. It definitely doesn't look like wine. Wine is full of tannins, and that is what we're going to give this lady. Some lovely dark booze. So the right way around, should the sides be darker than the upper oval? Not sure. I honestly don't know. It should all be quite dark. We'll just make the sides darker in a bit. Yes, okay. Water, Pierre, don't do that. Yes, and then we'll do a sort of circle here. In brown. I'm being impatient again. No, that's not dry yet, Pierre. You're being impatient again, my boy. That looks almost like she's drinking Bovril. Maybe she is. Maybe that's just her vibe today. Could people stop harshing it, please? Yes. Is it a risk to start putting in dark brown lines on this chap's face? It is a risk, but it's a risk I feel compelled to take, I'm afraid. Yeah, it's given it a certain something. I don't know if it's a good something, but it's certainly given it a certain something. Yes. And a bit of water. We can do it to this lady. She's a bit too pale in these areas. Yeah, the structure of her very bones is something to be marveled at. Doesn't quite make sense. What are we doing now? What colour should the background be? I'm going to say blue. like the depth that that gives it. Not emotional or spiritual depth, of course. We're long past that. We're far beyond expecting that of old Pierre and his work. No, no. God for this woman with big black hair. It's really helping us out. Okay. Sometimes what's quite nice is you can just leave a blob of watercolor on its own, just let it hang there, and it'll still move when you come back to it. It won't have stuck to anything. It won't get in the way of progress. I feel as though the lettering should be floating in a kind of whiteness to keep it very, not so much striking as legible. It's almost suggestive of a thought bubble, but not quite. Shade on her dress there. We'd be wrong to be disappointed with how this has gone. It's gone all right, I would say. Let's see. Okay, now then, we return some of that naughty old black ink. Just to neaten up some of the corrections here. There we are. Now, any last bits of shading, this is the time to do them, specifically on the skeleton. Mm-hmm. dark, in fact. See, a bit of a chin there. Round it out there. Okay. Yeah. That's the sort of thing we were after. I'm trying to almost make it look like that burnt guy from Beetlejuice, which I watched the other day. A real suggestion of continuous body horror here. Which is always fun, isn't it? Bit of the old body horror. Yeah, nice teeth lines. That's what's missing. Some teeth lines and some brow lines. And I think if we want to be really cool, we can do some white acrylic on top of this. This is very, like, I think I accidentally bought the really heavy, gloopy stuff. I'm not sure. I definitely have too much of that stuff somewhere. I don't really know what to do with it. Not my style, to be perfectly honest with you. It's just not my style. Right, let's see what we can do. I knew there was some water on there somewhere.
There we go. I think that's
us. For good or for ill,
I think that's us. And
that might be in a pamphlet near you soon. Let's quickly. Some more white on here.
There we go. Well, thank you for watching another one of whatever these are, these doodles. And like and subscribe and send it to anyone you know who likes whatever this is, ASMR, I don't know. And thank you very much and goodbye.